the most problematic, shocking, and faith-shaking verses in the Qur'an. Well, to Ridwan at least. Ridwan says that when he read the Qur'an the first time, this was one of the verses that stood out to him, and it played a role in him leaving Islam. As you can see in the title of the video, this verse is the one that speaks of the sun setting into a murky spring. I'm sure that I've read this verse over 100 times, and I've never really been affected in the same way that Ridwan has been. Surely, that's because I'm not as smart as he is. Oh, I'm gonna enjoy this one. Let's get to the video.
Until when he reached the setting of the sun, he found it setting in a spring of dark mud, and he found near it a people. The sun goes there for a bath after the day, I guess. Many Muslim apologists of our time try to argue that the Quran verse is misunderstood, or was just mistranslated. That's absolutely not true, but stay with me and see how they do that. The first way of making the Quran not look too embarrassing is to corrupt it and to make it correct again. If you search on Google for this Quran verse, you will likely land on Quran.com, which features the Sahih International translation of this verse. In that translation, you will see that they edit something that doesn't exist. The verse suddenly says that he found it as if it was setting in a muddy spring. See how they lie to you?
Ridwan is correct in saying that this is an addition to the text. However, it is not a corruption. Ridwan seems to not be aware that the inclusion of brackets is an indication that the word as if were not in the original text. Ridwan is correct in saying that this is an addition to the text. However, it is not a corruption. Ridwan seems to not be aware that the inclusion of brackets is an indication that the word as if were not in the original text. Ridwan is correct in saying that this is an addition to the text. However, it is not a corruption. Ridwan seems to not be aware that the inclusion of brackets is an indication that the word as if were not in the original text. Ridwan is correct in saying that this is an addition to the text. However, it is not a corruption. Ridwan seems to not be aware that the inclusion of brackets is an indication that the word as if were not in the original text. Ridwan is correct in saying that this is an addition to the text. However, it is not a corruption. Ridwan seems to not be aware that the inclusion of brackets is an indication that the word as if were not in the original text. Had this been an intentional corruption of the text, the brackets would not have been included in the first place. To be honest, this has nothing to do with the video. I'm just going out of my way to show that Ridwan doesn't seem to have any idea of the basics.
Here we come to
your fellow Muslim believer asked you about a hadith in which Muhammad says that at sunset the sun goes, travels, floats, swims to prostrate itself under the throne of Allah, and it comes back to rise again on the other side in the morning. And they struggle with this because how does the sun go anywhere? You don't even respond to that. And you think your best response is to reference a video in which the Muslim apologist does not explain it either, but says that this is a matter of metaphysics, which we cannot understand.
So I told the person to go and watch that video. I clearly said that Fareed Responds made a video about it where he answers this question based on proofs and knowledge. So go watch that. There you will find the answer.
Of course, this begs the question. How does the sun go under the throne? And the answer, as you can assume, is that it is a metaphysical matter. The throne is not observable, nor is the sun's prostration observable. So don't expect NASA, let alone Ridwan, to debunk this using science.
And you think that is a solution to your doubts, the doubts of your fellow believers? Are you kidding me? Do you think everyone is like you? Do you think everyone is willfully stupid and ignorant? Is this really what you want to go for? A matter of the unseen, of the metaphysical, which we can't understand. If it clearly doesn't make sense, if it's clearly stupid and ignorant, then it's metaphysical. We can't understand it. It's pretty clear to me why you don't want people to engage with the contents of critics and why you don't want to engage with the critics themselves. But hey, it doesn't look good on your mission. The debate challenge goes out, accept it or reject it, as you wish. Thanks everybody, and stay away from Islam.